my goddaughter with me on vacation, and then I was like a bird. I was like chicken around my little baby, you know, my little egg. I was like feeding her, washing her, like doing everything. And my husband said like, oh my God, you're like, you're not putting any attention to me. Like, what kind of mother you gonna be? I'm like, oh my God, really? Like, when I'm gonna have a kid, I'm gonna be like obsessed. Come on. My family, that's number one. I miss Russian TV. I miss Russian language. I miss Russian food. I miss the attitude of the people, you know, like I miss how people are so, you know, close to each other. I miss how they're like, you know, they're really raw people. They can tell you everything straight what they think or not, you know. I miss that. I also miss the winter time sometimes. I know it's bad to say, but I like it, like this coldness and snow everywhere around, the craziness of winter. I also like it. It's fun, in a way. When you're sitting inside, it's fun. When the lights go down and there's no one left, I can go on and on and on. Give it to me, yeah. No one's gonna show me how. Give it to me, yeah. No one's gonna stop me now.
What kind of movie would you like to be in? Comedy, drama, adventure, horror?
I think drama, like, I think something like what is real to people, not something like something more like a normal feelings that people have, you know. I like a lot like dramas about love and stuff like that. I think it's really always touching, something like what's really close to people. Or maybe I can, I don't know, play some crazy witch too. I don't know, something like that.
The beautiful witch?
The really ugly one, you know, with scars and everything. Like a zombie movie, imagine. That could be a lot of fun. To try out the new like makeup styles.
If you had a time machine, what period, forward, backwards, would you want to go to?
I like 18th century of Russia a lot. That was very beautiful time. With a lot of beautiful dresses, costumes, poetry, French in Russia, you know, it was like really good to speak French. All the writers wrote the best books and everything. So it's all like, I think it came from it from school because I was reading all these classical writers, like Tolstoy, Dostoevsky. So for me it was like Pushkin as well, his poetry. So it's really like, I don't know, something was really magical at this time. You're only here to win, get what they say. You're only here to win, get what they do. They do it too, if they were you. I liked a lot of different details, that's what I like. I like the strong coloring. I like jackets and pants. Basically, it was like really manly connection, and there was few strong colors. It was green, black, white. And I like the dresses, like evening dresses too, because like we chain like different things here. Very 20s in a way, you know? It was like really like that. I found it really cool, and I like the makeup and hair.
You like your bleached eyebrows?
I love my... I don't mind actually. I think this creates the very strong look in a way. seeing myself as a like as a professional, you know? Like, I don't take myself as a product or as muse. I think it's a mixture of together. And of course you have to be like somebody, you have to be your own person, you have to be your own personality, and you have to, you know, show and respect and everything. Everything goes so fast now because of the internet. Everything is on time, online. It's like a lot of possibilities nowadays too. I started when I was, you know, really young. I was 15, so I would learn step by step by step. So when I hit the moment of shows and a lot of like important jobs, I was kind of prepared for that. But I think now it's like because of everything moves so fast, I think it's hard for girls to jump when the baby to jump in this craziness world straight away when you're not used to it. For Roberto Ferretti, that was a really, really huge step in my career. The shot with Helmut Newton, you know, it was like I was working with Maria Carla, so it was like all these amazing people next to me. So they started me, they were like pushed me out there, and then of course my agency is like the biggest supporters of me. My agents in Milan, in New York, and in Paris, they like always give me like so this like believing in me, believing. After this fashion week in New York, Karine Rothfeld, she came in my life, and then she brought me to the cover of Range Vogue, you know. First editorial shot, and she gave me cover, and I was like overwhelmed, and I didn't even understood exactly what it's gonna get to me, you know. I was like, oh my god, I was so happy to see myself on the first cover. Then Frida, she helped me a lot when she came over. We've done so many beautiful campaigns, done so many beautiful shows together, we've done so many fun times besides work. Emmanuel actually helped me so much, you know, like we worked so much. It's like, you know, I feel so close to those people, they're like family. I'm so thankful, I'm so blessed that, you know, the people, they still, you know, I'm still working with them. You know, they have this exchange of energy, you know.